ask in your name, but whatever we decree shall be established. Lord, we thank you tonight. Oh, Riasi. Oh, Rabaseya, Mori Shila, Moruba, Taylor of Horabasa. Oh, we thank you. We rejoice in you. Oh, we rejoice. Oh, we rejoice. Oh, we rejoice. Oh, we rejoice. Oh, we rejoice tonight. Oh, we rejoice. We rejoice in you. Alamayanta. Tori Adalamasi. Tori Arabokoramanishe. Oh, we rejoice in you, Lord. We give you the glory, do in your name. Do to your name. Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord. Haya, Sharabande, Shandaraboshita. Hey, Lord Abahurabana. Thank you, Lord. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Haya, Rabahaya. Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, hey, hey. Takasabago. Tasanomani. Hey, Lord of Baha. Yes. Yes. Halabahora Baha. Yes. Satan is defeated. Hey, hey, hey. Hayarabonosata. Lord, we thank you that all the promises in you are yea and amen. Oh, we give you praise and glory for them tonight. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah. 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 Praise your name. Praise your name. Hey, yes. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Rabakanda Lambokusha. Oh, praise and praise and praise. Praise and praise and praise. Thank you, Lord. Oh, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Oh, God, I'm going to bless you.
Thank you. Yes. 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 Y'all believe it? Y'all believe it? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Is it higher? Higher. Oh, the canals? Yeah. Higher. Everybody broke, y'all be. Hang on to that.
Thank you.
Y'all's praise team.
They showed up.
Showed up. It was great, man. You know, when you were singing, you know, since, you know, my time has been short with them, you know, but watching them praise, man, you know, because they're really, you know, it's all about God. It's not, has anything to do with show.
Amen.
It's about, it's all about God, and you can see it and you hear it in their voices. And just to be a part of that and watching the people, you know, in the audience, it was so amazing, man. They didn't want us to stop. Brother James didn't. Brother James, boy, the spirit just took over him, man. He was on those drums, man, and he just kept going. After we just sit down, he was still going, man. And
the atmosphere, the anointing in the church was amazing. He's really, really a talented brother. And he definitely plays for the Lord. I mean, it was just, he was just caught up. But it was a good day. Let's say it was a good day. Amen. And then the fellowship we had Sunday evening, we had dinner, courtesy of Brother Mariko and Pastor Hill.
Sister Jessica.
And Sister Jessica. Right. Really thankful, man. Thank you for our dinner. So we had a wonderful time fellowship last night. So we had a good day yesterday. It was great. It was really spirit filled from the beginning to the end. And I'm so blessed to be a part of all of it. And I thank these sisters, man, that I've seen with y'all are so amazing. So amazing. There's nothing like you. Nothing like you. And I thank you.
Amen.
So Pastor Hill, you have something you'd like to
do? Maybe the ministers do.
I got something I want to say to Baptist. This is a testimony. Some people gonna get it, some ain't. And some are gonna say, "Has she lost her mind?" No, I haven't lost my mind. I just found it.
Just found it.
Love. You know, we went on the fast. I can't remember how. Two or three weeks ago, I can't remember. But anyway, the Lord was there. Well, I was talking to him and asking him about, I said, "Lord, I want something that I can tell people that it don't be, that it, you know, it's not easy. Somebody that's really in the Word, but you'll see where I'm going. But anyway, you know, Jesus came for us to have life and to have it more abundantly."
Amen.
Okay, so we was memorizing scripture, and I said, "Ooh, I just can't remember. I write it down, I try to remember, then I can't remember." Well, the Lord let me know, you know, we got the mind of Christ, and we got to watch what we say instead of saying, "I can't remember." I need to say, "I can remember." Because he came for us to have life and to have it more abundant. And then let me show you how Satan messed with you. I said, "I am 70. I said, "You know, when you go to the doctor,
17, 7-0?
70, mm-hmm.
Oh, my Lord.
Surprise. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Now, you know, I know that God's got all power. Mm-hmm. Okay, you know when you go to the doctor at certain age, they want you to do this and do that, and kind of like put you, Brother Wayne. But anyway, we got to know, the Lord let me know, we got to know that he came for us. Amen. I don't care what that doctor tells you when you go there, honey, you got a word to fight it.
Amen.
And they, when you get a certain age, they going to tell you, know where you see now, but you're going to get this, you're going to get that. But the Lord took me, he took me through the Bible and started showing me Abraham, started showing me Sarah, and I just, you know, I said, you know, he come for us.
Amen.
Even though something try to come up on you, you got your mouth. You can say, "No, mm-mm. Get off my body in the name of Jesus." No, yeah. You can't stay on this body. This is God's body. Leave me alone. You know,
Amen.
That was because of that fast that we went on, and my mind kind of cleared. And then it was saying, just like I said, well, you know, you said you're supposed to be going down. But see, the Lord don't look at it like that. Just because you're 70, honey, you just in your prime. But if you go up there and let that doctor tell you that, and you start thinking that, mm-hmm, instead of saying what Jesus wants us to say, you know, we
Amen.
We just go on down, but we listen to the Lord, listen to him, he's going to pull us through. And I start saying, "Honey, I can remember. I can do this."
Yes. Amen.
All things through Christ.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah.
You got it.
But see how Satan messed with you. Well, you know, you're getting 70 years old, so you know you're going to be kind of going downhill. But you know, the Lord let me know, honey, I'm in control of you.
That's right. That was his word to say.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Exactly. It's like, who's the poor that we going to believe?
Amen.
And then, even though if you do get sick, He gonna pull you through. Because I was there when Denise was sick. Mm-hmm. I saw Denise every day, honey. Denise had, all I got to do is say, I know it's a God.
I have an 86-year-old brother in Arkansas. He's the one that's been preaching. Some of y'all probably know him. He has been an evangelist for many years, and he's pastored two churches. And he's kind of known nationwide. Ever since I can remember, he's been praying every morning at his church. And we have people that come too at 6:00. Mm-hmm. And they talk the word, speaking the word, and praying the word, and all that. Mm-hmm. And I talked with him yesterday. He said that James is amazing. I'm 86 years old. I don't have an aching, a nerve pain. Mm-hmm. I don't have any health issues. And he's just amazing. I ain't bothered by nothing. I can eat anything I want.
Glory.
So it does make a difference.
Yeah. Right?
What comes out of your mouth.
Yes, it does. Mm-hmm.
All right. So that's the reason why we are constantly encouraging y'all. Amen. Let's begin to
speak it, talk it.
I think the word itself says the word bringing healing to the flesh.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Life to them with wounds, healing to all our flesh.
Mm-hmm. It's funny because the scripture that I came in here today was actually 2 Timothy. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love.
Hallelujah.
Keep going though. It said, but be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of God. I think a lot of times we go in. Went about the testimony, you know what I'm saying? Like we sometimes, you know, you're in front of the doctor and the doctor tell you a report and you receive it.
Mm-hmm.
As opposed to, you know, well, doc, I appreciate what you got to say, but the words with confidence. Sometimes we back up and we take what the doctor say and we receive it.
Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm.
But like it says here, therefore, shame, be not therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but be thou partakers of the affliction of the gospel according to the power of God. Now, what's funny about that scripture is he wants you to partake in the affliction that he took.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we was talking about last week, that emotional connect to what the suffering that he suffered. Right, we was there with him.
Mm-hmm.
See, so you can't be ashamed when you there with him, cause you know what he been through.
Mm-hmm.
Right,
exactly.
You know who have saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to your words. See, not according to what you say, Doc, that I've been eating. You understand? Not according to your word. But according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world even began.
Yep.
Huh? So, man, you said 7-0. I got a lot to look forward to. He looked that good at 7. I can't wait.
That's right.
Yeah.
But you know, when you get things, you know, we have to keep the word of God, because I tell you what, you have them little thing, like I said, well, you know, you're getting 70, so that's probably, you're trying to say that you don't want to get, you know, nothing happen to you and stuff like that, but you got to go by what the Lord tells you. Say what the words say, honey. This is my powerful book right here.
Yes, say what God says you are. Come on, okay.
Amen. Appreciate it. Minister Dave. Mr. Wayne, you have something like that?
In particular, I just thank you for what the message was, Dorothy.
Oh, yeah.
That was awesome.
That was real good. A lot of scriptures that she ministered on that some of them I have taught on myself. She just brought it from a different perspective.
Yeah.
And kind of like our pastor kind of admonished us a lot to, you know, to go back over the scripture that you know, he given us.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's things in there that you didn't see the first time you read. And there have been same time that things that I have spoken to you all, now go back and look at it again, and it just be one other thing he shows me in there. And that's why sometimes you hear, when I get up there, it's not the same old thing over and over again. But it's something right in there that he showed me that was different from the last time that I didn't even see it. So it's very important that we meditate or go back and review the scriptures that we have been taking down. Because in it, God's going to show us something, reveal something to us that's going to help us. And I think one of them, she was bringing out about, well, I think what I had brought out about the lepers, where they came and asked Jesus, the Lord, have mercy upon me. And then Jesus told them, said, go show yourself to the priest. And as we know the story, as they left, they was healed. But only one came back. And Jesus said, oh, well, they're not 10 of you all. See, he expecting us to give him the praise of what he's doing in our lives.
Yeah.
I mean, he's really looking forward to that, because when that one came back, I think it's in King James Version, he said, only one came back, this stranger. Now, he called this person a stranger, but yet this stranger received something from the Lord that a lot of even us is seeking for. And who do he call us? Do he call us a stranger? He called us the brethren, because we have a relationship with him. We have a very close relationship. It shows me that if he done it for this stranger, how much more would he do for me?
Yes.
Being I have accepted him as my Lord and Savior, is number one. And then we are the brother, and we call his father our father. And, oh, man, like I said, I've read that so many times. And I went back and I saw that, and he showed me that particular part of that scripture there, that this stranger received a healing. As a matter of fact, he received wholeness. He received something that the others didn't get. Because one of the scriptures said when he came back and prayed to God, he fell up on his face up on the ground and gave God praise for what he had done, and that he had recognized that happened in his body. How many times we have, you know, God have blessed us and done remarkable things to in our lives. Have we ever fell on our face and really thanked him? Really truly gave him the praise that is due unto his name? And really blessed him and thank you for what he have done? Hallelujah. Glory to God. And in return of doing it, because, you know, praise take it and presenting yourself in worship, that's another avenue to say, I believe in what you have done to me. And that's why Jesus turned around and said, go, your faith has made you whole. So he receives something different than the other nine did not receive. Because most times when you talk about you want to heal, they were healed for a specific need, which was the leprosy that they received. But this one person who received totally whole.
Yes.
Oh, God. Hallelujah. because he came back and offered worship and praise to God and thanking him. And the rest of them did not even you know, take the time to come back and give him thanks and glory for it. They just went and did obedience to what he had said. But he still did depend on them. He still was looking for them to give him praise and thanksgiving for what he'd done. And it, even when I was alive, an understanding that God have done to it, he still wants to give thanksgiving and praise for what he had done.
Amen.
And praise in advance for what you believe in for. That before you receive the manifestation of what you're believing him for.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you give him what he desires, mm-hmm. what he is expecting for us, mm-hmm. he'll give us what we're expecting for. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. But anyway, that's
good. Yes. One thing you said, Brother Wayne, you said that I was reading, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back with a loud voice. Sometimes we might not, you know, we might not do it from our heart. We don't put our total being in. With a loud voice, glorified God, and fell down on his feet, and just fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So I think that, remember years ago, we first introduced the seven dimensions of praise.
Mm-hmm.
And there are certain degrees of praise that will cause God to do a whole lot more.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that we really need to realize that if you're on level one, you're not going to get what you will get if you're on level five or six.
Mm-hmm.
So with a loud voice, amen. He gave him, he worshiped the Lord. So I was thinking the other day, I said, maybe we need to kind of rehearse that, go back over that. Because sometimes we're expecting God to work all these miraculous things on level two. Amen. When we need to be at level seven. When we are totally engrossed in the Spirit of God and God can do things spontaneous, you know, as we maybe be singing in the Spirit. You know, that might be the breakthrough. In fact, the highest level of praise is to healer praise. Spontaneous singing. Just break out in the Spirit singing spontaneously. And so I was thinking that we might need to revisit those seven levels of praise.
Yeah.
Down here on, you know, just level one, and you know, haven't even gotten have a breakthrough, not even flowing. You know, God can't do a whole lot. I always also wanted to mention, Sister Grenada, it was about, it's been several weeks since the Lord was dealing with me about, you know, getting with Sister Brenda and start doing a whole lot of the medleys that are based on redemptive realities that really kind of echo basically all that Jesus has done for us, especially mm-hmm. during the 3 days and three nights that we are teaching about. That's been on my heart for several weeks, and we had a whole list of them that we were just kind of waiting for the right time to release it and to get, you know, to get people back into the flow of it. Because I think that these medleys shouldn't just be sang by the praise team; they should be sang by members. They need copies of these methods, and they need to practice this and get the word into them by some. And I was just waiting and waiting. I said, I don't know when, I don't know whether Sister Brenda is ready for this. I know we used to do it at work. I just wait. I said, I don't know what to do. And then last Sunday, his wife started it. She started that medley thing, did four or five songs together, and how anointed it was. So I knew that it was God's time. And then yesterday, one of the main medleys that I rehearsed, that's been on my heart for about a month or two. That one of the songs that Sister Juanita sang yesterday, Jesus Paid It All, and explains all of the things that Jesus went through and all. And when she sang that, I said, uh-oh, it's time. So I talked to Sister Brenda last night, and we're supposed to be meeting tomorrow. But that was a real blessing, the song, Jesus Paid It All.
Yeah,
three or four other songs connects with that same thought, you know, rather than one. Next time, maybe you can sing all of them. It's powerful. And this is what I think that God is leading us to do
we got to bring the anointing in, and we, you know, we just don't want to do things the same way all the time. You know, bringing the anointing in through songs based on redemptive realities, I think that that's a breakthrough in itself.
You know, Pastor, it kind of starts with what Sister was talking about, you know, in our situations and our circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think sometimes we come to church, but the practice comes when you go home and you get the doctor's report. Mm-hmm. And you know, I was thinking the other day, I actually saw myself, I wanted this car, so I saw myself buying the car. Mm-hmm. And then I actually saw myself praising God when I bought the car. You know what I'm saying? Like, for some reason, we've gotten to this place in Christendom where we ain't got to do all of that. You know what I'm saying? And it's made us timid. Because I can remember those melodies that you're talking about. I can remember going to high school and I have my little earphones on, and boy, I might have been listening to the Whiners or something, you know what I'm saying? And I have my earphones on, and I'd be singing a little medley like talking about. Next thing I know, the whole bus sing. I done took my earphones out, you know what I'm saying? It catches. I mean, when I say it catches, I mean, I can see myself in the waiting room singing something. And everybody starts saying, because they need it. You know what I'm saying? And some, we haven't, we just blending in. You know what I'm saying? And so, if we get to start those melodies, man.
I think that we need to get words into everybody's hands. And if there's any way we can do a CD or something, not to sell, but just to let everybody know how the net is gone.
Yeah.
And they could just practice all of these things. And I'm telling you, if you sing and get the word working in your circumstances on a daily basis or while you're going to and fro, man, you know, some days, you know, I just be caught up in singing songs like Jesus Paid It All, getting turned around, singing in the spirit, you know, things like that. But you never know how much that adds to you being able to, you know, stay in the flow spiritually. And usually when I come to prayer, you know, I'm not trying to get a breakthrough. You know, I'm ready to sing in the spirit in the morning. So that's the advantage of it. You don't have to struggle in prayer and trying to, you know, flow and to move in the spirit. So I'm excited. Suppose the choir can help us to get this rolling, and we could have a service going on an hour or two. You know, just song after song, and just let God use the singers, let Him use us, let Him break in the spirit, and prophesy in the spirit. You know, it's going to be some supernatural manifestation when they get broken. You know, it might take a little fasting, but I think that once we get these songs at our disposal, begin to fast and pray, and then begin to unite in prayer, and begin to sing them to the glory of God. Especially if they're focused on the redemptive things, you know, that what Christ has done. That's where the power is, and anyway, that's where the power. If you really want to get sung that's full of power, just sing those that's focused on what Christ has done for us. Sister Wayne.
I just want to share, I don't know if I shared it last week, but they changed my schedule, and I just keep the scripture just keeps going before me. What the enemy meant for evil for me, God turned it around for my good. Because they said I had to work on the weekends, but I still get to come to church, but I work 3 to 11, Saturday and Sunday. But so I told them I want to be off on Monday, and I want to be off on Friday, I want to be off on Monday to come to prayer. And I tell you, since the Saturday prayer, the 4-hour, Pastor Deborah, the Lord just has been staring me. And when you said about the songs, I have the songbook out, your song with the words, and it's going from song to song. Some songs I don't even know the tune, but the words, just, you know, just praising them, like, say, going up another level, another notch, and studying my word. And my Alicia's little doggy comes up with me. And I, You know, I would get up and look at, I used to get up and look at the doctors. I get up at a certain time after working all night. And now don't even turn on the TV and study my word and singing and praying and praising the Lord. You know, it's just some, just been having a good time with the Lord. But when you said about the songs, and it's just go from song to song, just worshiping Him. I got to one song, I couldn't think of the tune or what. Calls us Dorothy, she didn't know it, but it's He's my healer. You know, He's my redeemer. He's my Lord and all that He's done. You know, just been, so I know when you're saying about going up a level, just that singing and praising Him just takes you up another level. I think about when the Lord spoke to me and told me, He said to close my eyes and open up my big mouth. In other words, elevate my praise and my worship to Him. Realize that, you know, I'm worshiping Him and getting into His presence. And that's where the blessings and the anointing and all that comes from, the answers. So if you can get, you know, the people to singing or whatever to, you know, the word and what He's done.
Right.
You know, opening up the eyes of our understanding to what He's done, who He is. And what He wants to do for us, you know, it's just such a, I'm just excited, excited about Monday night.
That's the other side of the coin. The other side of the coin is that all of the sections in our meditation book that focus on dealing the highest kind of faith through Christ, the realities that relate to Christ's death, burial, and resurrection, you know, like our release from Satan's dominion, the life and the ability that we've gotten as a result of, you know, receiving the new birth. Our authority, power and authority as believers, God making us able ministers. It's all, you know, it covers almost every phase of our redemption. You know, there's several areas. You know, I want people to start saying those things so bad. I would say maybe if I offer those $100.
A what?
Just a thought. I want these things really released through y'all so bad. Maybe everybody just can take out a section. So I'm just gonna meditate, and then I can get up and just express the areas that really minister to me. We gotta get it out. We just gotta get it out. So it's the area in your last book that you have that deals with how to build the highest kind of faith. I know that, you know, confession is not all of it, but it's gonna begin with being in agreement with the Word of God. Dealing the highest type of faith through declaring and acknowledging God's word. It has the integrity of the word, and it has a whole lot of the our release from Satan's power, has the life, ability, and fullness of God that we have received. You know, God has done all of these things for us, and we never mention it. We never say it. It doesn't ever hardly come out of it. At least I don't hear. Y'all might be doing it private.
Hey, Pastor, have you noticed, I believe that the enemy has attacked music just in itself.
Right.
I think about, you know, when I was younger, the choirs was huge. I mean, people just kept coming and coming. Now it's just praise and worship team. You know what I'm saying? Like, we looking at y'all. You know, I'm remembering when we kind of broke out the Word of Faith. I mean, I didn't care. We not only had a choir that was the length of the pew, you know what I'm saying, for just the regular adult, but our youth choir was the length of the pew. You understand what I'm saying? And I can remember I played in the orchestra. Wow. I'm in the pit. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about, I'm all city band, I'm on the end. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I mean, musicians, I'm talking about, like, and so, for some reason now, I mean, even if you see a choir on TV, it's four people in five rows, you know what I'm saying? Like, so we've taken ourselves out of the game, out of the emotional connect to that. And so I'm remembering that revival kind of like the late 90s, you know what I'm saying? 95 through kind of that 98 deal. I mean, we working on all cylinders, and for some reason, when it comes to those things itself, music, we just kind of like... We ain't got to do all of that.
that's the one reason we got our phase one and two, because we didn't have enough mics. We was anticipating a whole lot more singers and musicians coming through here.
Praise.
So we're just getting prepared. Amen. Sister Brianna just said that last night. She said in the summer, she's going to be a part of her intern, whatever she has to do to get her degree. Her master's, she said that she's going to do that this summer here, so she's going to be involved just about the entire summer, just building the music.
It's kind of funny, we had a couple of musicians that came. You didn't know that, but Kenny's a drummer.
Whoa.
So the first thing, I mean, it's musicians that have traveled that are going to come through, and that was the first thing he said to me after we called him. He said, "Dad," he said, "man, y'all got a real nice sound system up in there, man." He said, "you know, there's a whole lot of people down there." His wife said, "Well, we're going to come back. I like the spirit in that place." And she's a songbird.
Yeah, she's a praise and worship.
And so that's gonna happen, man. Ooh. And I'm talking, you know, these people are coming from major ministries. I mean, and they have their own ministries, you know.
Right.
And so you kind of called it, you know, in terms of what you saw in the spirit. Those things are happening today. Yeah. And so I'm excited.
Absolutely. The young man that was from RIU yesterday, he's blessed too.
Yeah.
I don't know who I haven't talked with him, but I think I'll give him a call today.
I have something that I want to say, kind of like a testimony. I've always said since I've been here that the foundation in my house is going to change. And Gloria, since we've been coming here, at first they didn't want to be a part of the praise team. She wanted to praise dance, but she didn't want to sing or any of that. And we had started a fast in the house to where everyone had to do something. The music that was being played in the house, if it didn't have anything to do with Christ, it wasn't to be played. There was no TV. We just cut out certain things in the house. Since she's been participating with the praise team, you're talking about a 100-degree turnaround. I don't remember what morning I woke up, but I woke up and my spirit was troubled for some reason. Gloria. And after the fast, she decided that she was not going to be playing any more secular music. So she began to pray, to play, and I think this is her favorite song. It's the one that Sister Courtney sings, For Your Glory. This little girl plays that song every morning. And I remember her playing that song, and just to kind of piggyback off of what you guys has been saying, it's something about when you're playing songs that emulate the word of God, it really does change the atmosphere. This girl began to play that song, and whatever was troubling me, it left before I'd even realized it. And her attitude has completely changed. Instead of having a child that likes to combat with you, she's really become one of the more completely different. But I'm seeing that
spirit has changed.
She goes forth here. It ain't no joke. And it's really changing the atmosphere and the lives of every one of us here.
Yes.
And I know sometimes it doesn't seem like we're in our word like we're supposed to be, but you can't help but be in it. With all this material, you can't help but to be in it. You can't help but to start, you know, practicing it. There's some things that's going on in my house that would have shaken me like a couple of years ago. I've got bills that is like, they're just seem like they're consuming me, but I just look at them and say, oh well, I'm not worried about it, it's going to get taken care of. Mm-hmm. And for the first time, it's not shaking me when something hits me. Mm-hmm. You know, God is going to take care of it. Other people is shaking around me, and I'm like, I'm not worried about it, it's going to be all right, it's going to get taken care of. Yeah. And he's never failed me yet, so it's like,
That's it.
We are getting it, Pastor. We're getting it, and so are these children.
That confession tonight that he read first about finances, that's one. So, a lot of times we have everything we need in these books, but sometimes we haven't found it yet. That's not me. Mm-hmm. All of those things, man, you just have to be led as to what to read and what to affirm. But your daughter did a great job yesterday too. I can see a lot of growth in her. Very good. And your mother shocked me.
She shocked me too.
She shocked me. I thought, she has her own position and prestige and experience, recognition in her church, and I couldn't. She's a Raymond graduate too.
Who was that?
The lady that joined church yesterday, her mother.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh man, she's beautiful. Uh-huh.
But I was just shocked. I just couldn't get over that. I kept telling Sister Hill, I can't.
You better believe it.
Yeah, but she was established minister, and she had her office position and certain things that she enjoyed doing and all of that. But we just praise God for God moving on.
Yes.
It was wonderful.
And we were hoping that she would find a way here to stay. And I really think that that 4x4 may have been something that really got her.
I think she's been planning this from the first time that she came.
Yeah.
I really think that it's.
Everything that's been happening, it's all just intertwined together. That's all for the good, for the good of us, and for the good of this ministry. We're intertwined. There's no I and me. Yeah. Like you were saying, some people had to, every church have to kind of weed out stuff, to make the rest of everything work the way it should. And sometimes when that's done, you see an immediate change. Mm-hmm. When we can work together and be comfortable to work together. We can plan together. We can cook together. We can just do everything together. It's so much better when everybody is on board, when everybody has the same vision, the Pastor Hill's vision, when we are working toward seeing that vision, be fulfilled. And we're doing it without egos and without deceit and without selfish reasons. We're doing it for the love of God.
Yes.
And for the love of this ministry. This house, man, this is so powerful, what we have here. That a North Side is just going to gravitate continually to this ministry. And then Tulsa will be gravitating to this ministry. And I promise you, you'll see people coming and some that was here will be coming back. You know, I see it, I feel it, and because our pastor never lost sight of his vision, he never veered from it. He never went left. He never went right. You know, just stayed on course.
The thing, Brother Travis, is that you have in this book, Stay Humble section.
Yes.
Having a service heart section. As we grow, the Lord began to bless. As we begin to get more people, we're going to have to begin to focus on stay humble. And I think that's huge. Most people don't want to meditate and confess the stay humble scriptures. But if you want it to stay humble, you're going to have to what? Confess that. Affirm that, just like everything else. So I think that if we can stay focused and y'all have a wealth of information. God's going to hold somebody accountable. So if you don't ever, if you don't even know what's in here, and, you know, we really need workers in this industry real bad. We need some strong, established workers. And the strength and the ability that you're going to have to carry out God's will is going to be things you affirm. If you don't affirm that you're able minister, if you don't affirm these truths in here, it just won't happen. Everything happens by what? By affirmation. You have to really begin to, you know, to speak things and call things that be not. All that God has done for us, over 2,000 years ago, it never will be done in us until we agree with Him in our confession. You got to go beyond that. You got to go beyond confessing to actually, you know, walking in love and doing everything else God says to. But that's the first major step. That's the first act of faith that you take after you receive, you know, salvation. You got to begin to call all of those provisions that Christ has made available. You got to begin to hook up with them and agree and claim them if you want that to be manifested in you. It's already done, you know, over 2,000 years ago, legally. It's been done for you, but it's not going to be done in you until you find them and discover them and begin to what? Affirm them. And they will gradually become alive after you begin to what? Speak them forth.
Amen. I guess we're coming to the end. We're at the end. Brother David, if you mind closing us out in prayer. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this time of prayer. Thank you for the word that went forth today, Heavenly Father. That we'll meditate on it, Lord God. That we continue to practice it, Lord God. Not just in word, but also in deed, Lord God. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the wonderful pastor that you placed before us. We ask that you continue to bless him and his wonderful wife, Lord God. Continue to give him vision. Continue to give him insight, wisdom, revelation, favor with you and man, Lord God. We just thank you, Heavenly Father, that you continue to bring laborers into this ministry, Heavenly Father. Well able to do your work, Lord God, your workmanship, Lord God. We ask that you bless each individual in this room and in our members of the church, Lord God, that they continue to seek you, Lord God, and that you'll continue to give them wisdom, knowledge, understanding, that their spiritual eyes be enlightened, that they know what the hope of their call is in you, Lord God, and what your riches and their inheritance of the saints truly is, Lord God. So we just thank you, Heavenly Father, for Christ. We thank you for what he suffered, Lord God, that we were there with him, Lord God. And Heavenly Father, we thank you that he ascended and sat down at the right hand, that he is the head and that we are the body, his workmanship, Lord God. So as the head tells the body what to do, Lord God, we thank you, Heavenly Father, that we'll line up, that we'll step where we're ordered, Heavenly Father. And we thank you that the manifestation of your word, that the manifestation of our spirit, Lord God, shall be in operation, Lord God, in grace and in truth, Lord God. So we just thank you that we're establishing your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven, as we go forth, continuing in your spirit, Lord God. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. And all the people with that prayer said, amen.
Amen. Amen.